Hey guys, welcome back to Naughty Styles. Today we are taking you on board of all custom, beautiful, unique, Down East super yacht. Welcome aboard Essence of Cayman. She's a Veachem 85.
Wow, this is definitely one of the largest Down East style yachts I've ever been on.
I think it is the largest I've ever been on.
This is so cool.
Yeah, it feels so beautifully nostalgic. So she was built in 2006. All the woodwork you guys are gonna see, it's all custom, one of a kind. There's a lot of custom designs on board that was, of course, preference of the owner. So it has this beautiful nostalgic feel, but she was born in 2006, so she's pretty young.
Really cool. So you have these side boarding doors, right?
Mm-hmm.
If you close that up and you close the stern door up, you have a complete enclosed safe space to move around.
Veachem is a Turkish shipyard, and this was one of the very first largest yachts they've ever built. There's a lot of custom features on this yacht that you will not see on any other Veachem. So part of this one is very interesting, how this is sunken down, because this area here is actually headroom for the master cabin.
Oh, got it. Okay.
Yeah.
Get a little more space underneath. Yeah.
All of this is loose furniture. So whoever buys this yacht next can certainly decide to do something different here if they would like. And of course, we have this built-in seating area here. Really nice.
I can just imagine myself sitting there having a coffee or a cocktail like at sundown time.
The beauty of this size of an open cockpit like this, there's just something very romantic about it.
I really like that sunshade, which is like pulled up in the center of it.
Mm-hmm.
So instead of having just a flat sun sail, having it like this, it gives you a little bit of like a nostalgic like tent feel.
What is it connected to?
Oh, the mast.
Of course.
Oh, it's like a whole setup like this.
Yeah, really cool. All right, since you're already there, let's talk about what we've got here on the aft portion.
So we got some capstans here,
mm-hmm.
Fold you in aft, and then of course the pole for the sunshade. So we have the stern door here leading down to the swim step. Here's your two-step ladder going down to the hydraulic swim step, which houses the tender right now. Pretty large swim step actually, really cool.
How big is the tender?
I want to say it looks like a 15, 16 foot tender. And it looks like it actually could even house a bigger tender.
Yeah, it's pretty large. I mean, if the weight capacity
the
allows,
weight capacity
right?
The weight capacity is allowing
All right,
it, yeah.
Come on up. So this second door, it took us a second to figure out, is actually for the passerelle that comes out from right there.
So if you don't want to go to the swim platform, you use this door here, and that's your boarding.
Yeah, boarding access, passerelle out.
Well, that makes sense.
So here we have, looks like just some storage areas here.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, storage on both sides. Wow, how did you see that? I didn't even see that. So we have a sink here and a bar. That's really beautiful.
So cool.
And then on this side, we actually have a drink fridge.
Oh yeah,
uh-huh.
Great. Let's walk forward, check out the foredeck.
Let's do it.
Wow, that's a comfortable walkway.
Very wide. Look at this bow. Wow. This is surreal. Just to give you guys perspective.
You can actually really get a good idea how big, how large this boat is.
This is very impressive.
The style of the boat is definitely a little bit deceiving in regards to the size of the boat. So now thinking of Florida,
yeah.
Inner coastal.
Oh.
Having bridge clearance issues with tall boats, well here you're probably going to fit under most of the bridges without even asking for the drawbridge to open.
You will have some with that tent back there, you know, the canopy.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's definitely very convenient.
Very convenient.
And what a beautiful space to enjoy. You put some bean bags out here. Oh, just you got this cushion area. It's really, really nice.
So we have a layout pad right here. What's that behind you? Is it another layout area?
No, it looks like a window.
That's probably exactly what it is. It's just covered for sun protection right
yeah.
now to keep it cool on the interior.
Yeah.
Well, we'll see that on the inside.
All right, let's see what's at the bow.
So immediately as we see this big stainless steel protection plate here, and we have dual anchors, dual windlasses, and then let me open one of the anchor lockers so we can actually take a look at it. Oh, wow. That is very large.
Oh, wow.
So we have the two anchor chain lockers right there, one on the port side with all the chain, and then we have stairs leading down to, let's call it, storage area for fenders and lines. Pretty cool, actually, the way they use the space.
It is huge.
Yeah.
Look all right. at the size of this case. Look at that. Look at that. Okay, let's go back and check out the interior. Makes you want to wear like a big flowy dress walking
right.
down this.
Well, actually, I don't.
No, it doesn't?
No.
You just said right.
For you, yes. You not
can,
for me.
You can back out of this now. Big flowy dress for 500,000 subscribers.
For me? No.
Yeah. You wore a bikini once. What are you talking about?
I guess.
All right, should we check out the interior?
Yes.
So you have these beautiful sliding doors that lead us in.
Oh,
so immediately
gorgeous.
When you walk in on the port, we have this office working area. Giant screen, really nice. And on our starboard, we have a couple of storage cabinets here. Beautiful setup. What's unique about this vessel, which again was to the owner's preference, is that it actually has two salons. It has an upper salon and a lower salon. Very unique. So you guys can experience that as we are going forward. Another thing, all the woodwork is handmade, custom, beautiful wood, really timeless. And for example, like the AC vent, right? It's completely hidden.
Yeah, can't see, it's coming out there.
Can't see it at all.
Pretty cool.
You appreciate that. You like that,
I
right?
I appreciate that, yeah.
So we have a sitting area here.
Well, another thing that stands out to me, like massive headroom,
yes.
right? And
yes.
another thing which is really cool, you have a 360-degree view. I mean, forward, speaking of looking forward, unobstructed views forward, which is pretty unique on most power yachts, actually, having that layout like this on an 85-footer.
I can't even reach this on my tippy toes.
Yeah.
It's really, really tall. So a really nice sitting dinette here for easily six people.
Mm-hmm.
And a comfy couch area here. All right, keep going?
Yep.
All right. So as we keep coming forward, our helm is on starboard, and on our port side, we actually have
companion helm.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, look how nicely organized they have all the flags here. So nice.
Oh yeah, the flag storage.
Mm, beautiful.
That's cool. Mm-hmm. I like that.
Storage is here, and we have the helm.
Visibility is pretty awesome.
It feels very grand in here.
And then how about the helm bench? I mean, that must be one of the most posh helm benches
I've
ever seen.
I don't think that's a real word.
Probably not. All right, what do we got here? We got our generator, remote switches, and instruments right here. Shift and throttle control right here. We got the trim tab control here, fireboy here, a Garmin chart plotter, as well as a Simrad. The man engine monitors for each engine one. The bow thruster control, our ignition switches here, autopilot, all the tank gauges, of course, RPMs for the two engines, and analog engine instruments as well. It's kind of cool having the analog ones. I really like that. And great visibility. Look at the helm wheel. It's so beautiful. The woodwork is amazing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the woodwork is absolutely gorgeous. We have a couple of hatches up on top here. There's one here as well.
So for docking purposes, you have the sliding window. Also for cross breeze, you have the overhead hatches, the side windows, there's another sliding window on the port side, and of course the sliding door on the aft, so you can create some good cross breeze instead of using air conditioning.
And also, as you always say, pick your head out of the window, or pick your window out of your head. Whatever you say there, yeah. Anyway, so that's really great too. All right, let's go down to the lower salon.
Pointing out again, like the woodwork, I mean, look at the handrail, it's pretty cool.
Yeah, it definitely has this very grand feel.
So yeah, as we're walking down, we have our breaker panels here, pretty conveniently located as well, close to the helm. Oh yeah, that's what the cover was for.
It creates this like an atrium feel, it's pretty beautiful. So yeah, you can just remove that cover that we saw up above, and how beautiful would this look here. You didn't see a TV in the upper salon because there's one here. Huge TV here.
Very
tons
cozy.
Of storage everywhere around. And on this side, on our starboard, we have a proper dining area. The wood is just gorgeous everywhere. All right, let's check out the guest staterooms. So we're going midship, kind of going aft, but we are midship. We have two guest staterooms here. They look equal. Let's pick in a starboard one. Yeah, really beautiful. Tons of space to move around.
So there's a porthole there, right?
Correct.
Which, of course, it seems a little darker in here right now because of the dark wood.
There's plenty
of light could come in there.
I mean, it's definitely a style of a yacht that, you know, it's not going to be everybody's style, but it's definitely somebody's very special style here. So we have our head. Wow, this is very beautiful. This looks like one of the sailing yachts that you and I crewed for a little bit, right? It was an 80-foot sailing yacht.
Yeah.
It was also a Turkish build, I believe. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it has a very similar style. Definitely a very generous one person, possibly two person shower, but the one person on this side might not get the water.
And we have the head on the inboard side there.
And Rico's in the shower.
I'm in the shower.
Rico's in the shower. Okay. All right, let's check out the other side.
The port cabin. So it's a mirror image?
Yeah, mirror image. I like how they use the mirror here because it's definitely creates kind of a larger feel for the cabin. See what it looks like. Yeah, got a good size hanging locker, couple drawers, and also drawers underneath the bed. Yep, got a couple there, and a matching exact same head. Tons of storage everywhere, you guys. You kind of, it's behind the door, but once you close the door, there's access everywhere, mm-hmm. and there's a medicine cabinet right there. All right.
To the left.
Is that what I think it is? Yay! It's washer and dryer, separate units.
Oh, that's great.
It's laundry ready to be made. And if we keep going aft, there's our engine room.
Oh, so we're going to check that later.
So first, we're going to go forward and check out the galley. You guys know the way this works. You know the order.
Know the drill.
By now, you know the drill, right? So interesting, it almost feels like a sailboat.
A little bit.
Right? Like it has that feel, the wood.
Really cool galley, actually.
Gorgeous. Yeah, it's a compact galley, but it looks like nothing has been skipped on. So you've got a full, huge fridge. Big fridge. Freezer. Tons of storages. And two dual sink. One is larger than the other one. Storage everywhere. There's screw on board, so I'm not gonna open everything, you guys. We have a dishwasher, good size dishwasher, kind of perfect for the size. Trash compactor, a huge oven, and a microwave oven, and a 5-burner cooktop. And on this side, we still have all of this upper storage. A nice dinette. Look how this is resolved, kind of neat. You can just tuck it in when you're not using it.
It's like a breakfast nook kind of thing.
Pretty nice. And also a spot for a crew. Mm-hmm. It's their crew mess, you know, if the owners are using the rest of the boat, the crew can have their little private space here.
Totally.
So there are two crew cabins on board. We're gonna go and do a quick peek into the captain's cabin. Thank you, captain, for letting us quickly show it. So I'll let you peek in.
Oh, that's actually pretty comfy.
Yeah, so it is set up for crew of four, but obviously, I mean, two if you just need to run this boat, two can totally run it. And I think it has an ensuite. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and we have a shower right there. All the same finishes, the whole boat is finished the same way. So the crew area is finished with the same beautiful wood.
Cool.
All right, and now we're gonna go check out
the master.
I just want a flowy dress. All right, we're all the way aft.
Separate staircase.
And look how beautiful the staircase is.
Beautiful woodwork.
Wow. I mean, I gotta say, I really like the wood rails.
Yeah.
I'd rather have a wood rail than the
stainless.
Yeah, first of all, you don't need to constantly wipe it. And second of all, it just feels so nice.
Yeah.
All right, what's here?
Oh, storage.
No, a little drink fridge.
Oh, that's cool.
Clever. And a tiny microwave. This would be our coffee station, you and I, huh? A little tiny coffee without even coming up anywhere. Just have a little coffee thing. All right, welcome to the master.
That is a huge king. Is that a California king?
That's massive. You're right. It's extremely big.
Right?
Yeah, I don't think we would ever touch if we had such a big bed. Even if Marco was in the middle spread out, none of us would still touch. All right, so let's check out what we got here. We have a huge TV. This even got room to grow.
This
TV has room to grow.
You know what? It looks
grow.
Really nice. It's very classy. It's not like overly dumb.
I agree. It actually fits into the style of this boat, surprisingly. So we have tons of storage everywhere, all along here and here.
Is that a walk-in? Oh, it's a walk-in closet.
Walk-in closet.
That is amazing.
With like a nice drawers there. Everything is like beautifully finished. The floors are stunning. And then the bed has a couple of drawers built in as well.
Mm-hmm.
On each side, there's a settee here also with built-in drawers. Look how beautiful these are.
All the knobs and everything looks so classy.
And you could tell when it's like good quality because this yacht is not just a couple years old and none of them are looking like, you know, weathered. They look really nice. So there's a hanging locker in here with some personal stuff. So quick peek in here. All right, and we're gonna go into the head, which is very unique here, you guys. We have his and hers, Jack and Jill, but they're not identical. They're a little bit different. I'm gonna assume this is his. They have tons of storage here. Very nice. A huge Jack and Jill shower. For sure a two-person shower.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, really cool. And then come follow me through the shower. And this is hers. There's a bidet as well. And there's a nice little getting ready area here.
Oh,
your makeup
got it.
And stuff. So it's definitely set up a little bit different. And then when you come out, I get to show you another hanging locker. And we also have this really nice working area slash, you know, could be a makeup area, but I feel like you already have one makeup area. So this might as well be a really nice little home office here.
And a coffee machine.
And a coffee machine. Oh, dude. I like these owners. They think right. All right. And what do we have left?
We have left the engine room we need to show.
Let's do it.
Wow. That's a headroom in the engine room here.
That's very tall, you guys.
Also, here you can see this whole panel is, of course, permanently mounted right now, but it can be taken out if you ever had to repower the boat.
You are so right. Wow.
Pretty cool, right?
Actually, just getting any kind of equipment in here.
Exactly.
Right? That's pretty impressive.
So
all right, you do your thing.
What do we got here? We have two MAN 1300 horsepower V12 diesel engines, which are the main proportion, of course, on this boat. Top speed on this boat is 25 knots and a cruising speed of 19 knots, which is pretty good.
It's a very, very good cruising speed.
Yeah. This is interesting. The motors are mounted pretty much straight, if not even tilted forward.
That's what it feels like.
Yeah, but the shafts are going out in an angle, so the transmission has a little bit of an angle there. That's very interesting. I've never seen that like this before, actually. Usually the engines are already in line with the shafts. So two gigantic fuel tanks with side glasses right there. Fireboy suppression system. Then we have the Raycore primary fuel filters, pretty conveniently located as well there. Very organized engine room. Really cool. Two Onan generators each, 23.5 kilowatts. You got battery chargers right there. I mean, everything is straightforward. It's very easy to get to and to maintain.
And also very bright engine room.
Thanks to the LED lights, it's really bright in here.
I know.
Like operation room.
Sea strainers are here?
Yep. Sea strainers right there. And then, of course, our through holes all the way on the bottom of the hull.
Hey guys, this completes our tour of this 2006 Veecham 85 Essence of Cayman. It's a really nice name. I hope you enjoyed this. Let us know in the comments what you thought of it. Also, make sure you definitely, definitely, definitely check us out on Instagram. We do daily updates. So if you want to follow us along as we do all our traveling and do a lot more behind the scenes stuff there, definitely check us out on Instagram. Check out our Insta stories that we post daily. Also check us out on the Patreon if you're interested in liveaboard lifestyle and learning more about it. If you need some advice, definitely reach out on there. Thank you for all your likes. We really, really appreciate you guys doing it. We will never stop saying it. Really appreciate the comments, appreciate clicking that bell thing. I know that's not everybody do that, but please do the bell. The bell is important.
Well, I gotta say, like for me, I've always been interested in the Down East style motor yachts. This was the largest Down East motor yacht I've ever been on, we have ever been on, and they're really growing on me even more. I always found them interesting, the style, the design of them, but actually, you know, experiencing and seeing them, it's so unique. The layouts are very different than on conventional motor yachts or sailboats. It's such a cool layout. So that being said, enjoy the outtakes. And it even has a disco ball here. It really does.
Disco ball?
I mean, like a disco light for the party in the engine room.
Serious?
Engine room party tonight.
Well, this was going to be cut in there, but okay, sure. Enjoy the outtakes. Ciao.